himself up, and he walked around the palace, all bent over, but he had a heart of gold. The people loved him, his father and mother loved him, and he kept on growing, but his father wanted to do something special, and on his 12th birthday, he told his son, I want to do something special for you, because I love you, as my son, regardless of your condition. And so his father had a contest with the local sculptors, and they were charged to create an image of his son. But because of his son's condition, he was given to where he could go in the palace. So he never traveled outside the palace walls. So the sculptors were told that their creations had to be made and put in the garden outside of his window. And after about 3 months of him working and carving, mastering and examining, they all completed their project. And most of the artists made the image of the sun bent over. It was an exact replica of his sun. But there was one artist that decided to do something different. He made the image of a young fellow standing straight up with a smile on his face. And the young prince looked out the window at all of the sculptors, and he told his father, I like that one. The one of me standing straight up, you can get rid of everything else. I want that one. And so for every day, the young fellow would crawl out of his bed and go over to the window, and he peered out the window, and he saw himself standing straight up. And I want to tell you that something happened, because he had a good image, because he had a good model of what he should look like. By the time his 13th birthday rolled around, he had been looking at that image for 9 months. Every day he saw himself the way God created him, standing up straight. And on his 13th birthday, he was able to stand up and walk around, because he saw himself as God's image. And that's how it is with us. yeah. Free to praise him, yeah. Free to thank him, yeah. Free to tell somebody, yeah. That the wages of sin is death. Is eternal life.
Yes, sir.
We have the power to save. This word is power. It's not just a book, literary expressions, prose and poetry. Jesus says, the words I speak, our spirit and life.
Amen.
We have the power, yeah, to speak to those that are in bondage. As Jesus sent Moses into Israel, told him to tell Pharaoh, I am that I am. Said, let my people go.
Amen.
We can speak to the pharaohs of addiction.
Yes.
Say, let my people go.
Amen.
The pharaohs of the prison system, let my people go. The pharaohs of the educational system, let my people go. The pharaohs of the judicial system that is corrupt, let my people go. The pharaohs of the political system, let my people go.
Amen.
The pharaohs of alcohol and drugs, violence. Let my people go. We have the power to help other folk overcome that bondage to sin. You have been set free. You know that when you die, you're going to heaven. You know that when you meet up with a problem, you got a problem solver. You know it already, but somebody else there is suffering needlessly. They don't know that there's help available.
Yes.
They don't know they can have a 24 service of angels watching over them all night long. They don't know they can have twins following them, goodness and mercy, following them all the days of their life.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
And they just stay their suffering in their sin. It's incumbent upon you and I to do something about it. Harriet Tubman wasn't satisfied being free herself. Frederick Douglass was not satisfied being free himself. They went back. They spoke out. They spoke up about the injustice of what had happened.
Come on, man.
Martin Luther King said, until all of us are free, none of us are free.
Amen.
Any unjust law is a challenge against justice everywhere. So we've got to take the challenge where he gave it to us. Go ye therefore, teach all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Teach them to observe all things. And I don't care what type of bondage you have had to come out of, he fashioned you with a message that is tailor-made for somebody that needs to know the God of your suffering. I don't care if you lost three folks at the same time. Somebody needs to know the God of your suffering, the God of your healing, the God of your deliverance. You've got a different relationship with God based on what he's taken you through. And so now you need to go and share that good news with somebody.
Yes.
Slavery once was enough. Amen. We don't have to go back. Amen.
Amen.
Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. The doors of the church are open.